Hey, High Stern, I hate you. But I love you, boy.
Robin and I can't do the show tonight because, listen, Robin's biological clock is ticking, and we're aggressively pursuing having a baby, just like Maury and Connie, aren't we, Robin?
Yeah, I have to cut down my work schedule, and you have to stay at home all the time.
These two are nuts. Let me tell you something. I was working three jobs when I got my wife pregnant. Three jobs.
Can't she do face-to-face like this, that
yeah, right.
stupid TV show?
It takes 5 minutes. You can't do your job. Listen, watch this. This is the scene we'd like to see for Maury and Connie.
All right.
Hello, America. I'm Moriovich. Tonight, on An Internal Affair, older women, younger men, the story of the hag and the hunk. She's somebody's child, but she's in love with a ghost. Liz Taylor, once a violet-eyed, raven-haired beauty, but look at her now, cellulite with Academy Awards. What was that?
Maury, it's time.
I'm working. Not now, Connie.
We must aggressively pursue making baby.
Excuse me, Tokyo Rose, but I'm busy.
It's now, or little Mousy Ovitch will never be made.
Not now, Connie. I mean, there's tension in the Middle East, and we just found the secret tapes of Klaus von Bülow.
It's time. Temperature is just right.
P.U. Connie, what happened to the oral thermometer? I mean, someone has to work around here.
Listen, you, I make double your salary. We must do it now. All things are right according to ancient Chinese ritual. I eat lots of fish, stare at pictures of babies, and rub duck sauce on my breasts.
Well, how the hell is that going to help?
Couldn't hurt.
Until next time, America, tune in and see the Compeckney Stone.
Ooh, me so horny. Me love you long time.
Connie, for God's sake, I'm 50 years old.
54.
The hell was that? Not the way we wrote it, but I liked it. Okay, listen. Welcome, everybody. And this is the show. It's Saturday night. We got some good guests. Elliot Gould is here. And I'm going to do some acting with him. So are you, Robin.
Ooh.
Lisa Slee was here, someone who claims to be an actress. I've never seen her act.
We'll
I don't know.
We'll find out
That's
if
right.
she can act.
And we got some nutty stuff for you. A couple of interviews with... Who do you got interviews with? Ted Williams, Margot Kidder, and Donahue. Donahue, I like
Ooh,
that.
Ooh, Donahue.
That's right. And by the way, let me just say something. Something will be corrected tonight on the show, once and for all.
What's that?
Our producer, Gary Dell'Abate. A lot of you have written, and we've acknowledged exactly what's wrong with this program. We've figured it out. Our ratings drop every time Gary... I rely on Fred, Jackie, and Gary, and John for reaction shots.
They're the audience.
We don't work with an audience because I can't stand a live audience. Quite frankly, I don't want to sit there and be evaluated by you sitting in a live audience.
But you thought you could trust these three.
I thought I could trust them. Now, Fred looks good on camera. Jackie looks good on camera. Even John looks good. But Gary's teeth... Here's a tape. This is Gary reacting... We've done about five shows
These
so far.
Are reaction shots of Gary. Gary says it's a bad angle.
It is.
Yeah, the camera's on. That's a bad angle. But there's Gary reacting to the show.
What's wrong with that?
That's a blank stare.
Those are my teeth.
But I'm saying something funny.
We don't know that for sure. Fred's not laughing.
Look at this.
Look at
this.
My teeth aren't hanging.
He's licking his chops.
He's trying to keep them in his mouth there.
I can try.
He's wetting his chops. He's constantly... I mean... This is the guy I'm relying on.
There he goes, licking him again. They get so dry.
I mean, what kind of thing is that, to tell you the truth?
Well, he reacts when he doesn't understand.
Right.
So how are we going to help him?
So what we are going to do is we've been studying tapes of Iran and Iranian women. And quite frankly, what we found is that the reason Iranian women look so good is they keep the whole lower half of their face veiled.
This is true.
Where's your veil? You have it, okay.
Oh, it's beautiful.
If that veil comes off, Gary, at any point...
Oh, no.
What I will do is
Still
have...
Still not big enough.
That's the way it works.
Keep the veil on, and now I think this is going to work,
Let's
all right?
Let's see a reaction shot now.
Hey, don't... Eureka! All right, listen, don't go away. We'll be back. Lisa Sliwa, Elliot Gould, various interviews, the news. Don't move. All right, we've just been informed we're too low-key on this show, so... That's our executive producer. He's going to the Barry Sand Executive Producer School. And let me introduce our first guest, Robin. Try to react a little bit
I'm
when she comes
try.
Out. Lisa Sliwa. All right, Lisa. How you doing? Take a seat. Take a seat. There you go. Yeah, right.
Was that the kind of reception you've always wanted?
Definitely.
People screaming?
It's kind of like walking down 42nd Street in a miniskirt, you know what I mean?
There was a lot of debate before you came out, Lisa, that without the beret, you were so beautiful. The beret,
really?
I know,
there was a debate about
there
that.
Was, because a lot of people said, you know, well, she shouldn't wear the beret.
I don't think she has a top to her head.
Well, I felt I needed something. I mean, look at Gary. He's got a sheet wrapped around his mouth. And Howard, it's a great idea, because last time his breath. I mean, it's not just the teeth. It's the breath.
You are so much more beautiful without that stupid beret.
Oh, take it
you
off.
Really
come
are. Take it off. Let me smell the inside of your beret. Imagine to get a whiff of the inside of that beret.
Ooh. Hey, no way.
Do you sleep with that beret on?
Howard, I needed the beret. You know, first of all, I'm insulted. You send limousines for all of your other guests.
Right.
I got four telephone calls in the last hour before I was supposed to be picked up, right?
Right, right.
Do I get a limo? They go, the Lincoln Town Car has broken down.
Right.
We are sending a cab.
Right.
So I'm expecting like a New York City style gypsy cab with a twinkling lights, you know, big stereo system, some good music. They send some guy like a Jersey gypsy cab, right?
Right.
This car, the guy runs out of gas in Manhattan waiting for the tunnel. I mean, is this the way you treat your guests?
Lisa, you
I'm amazed
claim,
you even
you
have chairs.
You claim to be an international model.
Yes. Do we have? Howard, you claim to be a talk show host. I mean, look at you.
But I have a show. And whatever you'll say about me, whether or not I'm a talk show host or not, I have a show. But let me tell you something about Lisa. She also claims to be an actress.
Yes.
And I have yet to see her in any American... Have you ever been in an American magazine?
Yes, I have.
I'm talking about on a cover?
Yes, I have.
You have?
Yes, I have.
Because I don't see this
Howard,
modeling.
I tell you, we go through this every
Take
time.
Take off your beret.
Call
Take
my
Take off your beret, please.
No, call my modeling agency. They'll send you the portfolio, and you can see the whole book. That's
what
all
movie?
You have to do.
What movie have you done?
Where are your movies? I did a movie called Indigo, which will be released in late fall 1990.
Where is a clip of this movie?
I don't have a clip of the movie. If you had real producers,
Here is what we're
professional
gonna do.
Producers, that could call up the producer of the film to get a clip,
Here is
maybe
what
you
we're,
would have a clip.
Here's what we're going to do.
I mean, you're blaming me for the inadequacies of your staff. You know, that's what you men are all alike.
All right,
you always
calm
blame
down.
The woman.
Here
you
is
blame
what,
the woman. Damn. Shut up, you guys. You know, you're part of the problem, too.
Here is what we're going to do tonight.
I mean, at least you took Robin out of the glass booth that you have her in and out of the cage you keep her in on the radio.
Here is what we're going to do tonight.
If you keep spinning like that, I'm going to go back.
When Elliot Gould comes out tonight,
yes.
I am going to ask Mr. Gould, after we interview him, to
a
do...
Very
oh, Mr.
Famous
Gould.
Actor.
I'm Lisa Sliwa.
I am going
to seen
Gould.
Some of his movies.
I am going to ask Mr.
Yeah,
Gould.
Yeah, in 1970, they're on, like, reruns at 3 a.m. in the morning, right?
But they are movies.
Is he related to you and Gary? I noticed he's got that same kind of kinky hair.
All right, well, let me say something.
She's so sweet.
Elliot Gould is...
I love you guys, too.
Elliot Gould is a professional actor. What you will say about him, whether his movie aired in 1970 or 1980, doesn't make a difference. Really.
They weren't afraid to release it.
Exactly. Lisa's movies have never been seen.
Howard,
so how dare,
Howard, how can I take time to go out to Los Angeles to make a film when we have rapists on trial in the second
All right, wait a second.
That claim they didn't do anything.
Tonight.
We've got women bashing. We've got recording stars
how
promoting violence against women. And I'm supposed to go to Hollywood this is happening in New York?
Hey,
wait a minute.
How dare you make fun of Elliot
And men
Gould.
Like you try to silence us and invite us on a guest so that you have, you know...
Let me say something. Let me say something.
Yes?
Elliot Gould, I'm going to ask him in one of the segments. I've written a script called, instead of Bob and Carol, Ted and Alice, it'll be Robin, Howard, Lisa, and Elliot.
Okay.
And we will get in the bed and do the scene, and you will have your chance to act.
I have a mixed bag.
I want to see how you act.
You can see how I act because I am what you see.
All right,
you're
full of rage. You're full of rage. Do me a favor.
I'm
react
not full
to,
of rage.
React to these flashcards, all right?
What is this, a Wheel of Misfortune or something?
React
from
to
Lowell
this. Rudge? Dice
Andrew
Clay.
Andrew Dice Clay. This is what I'll tell you about
him.
The Dice Man? This is what I think about the Dice
why
Man,
you
okay?
Like the Dice Man?
That's what I think about the Dice Man. You got
all right, react
do you
to
have
this.
A lighter?
React
this
to this.
About the Dice Man.
Sit down. Bob Goldthwait. What do you think of him?
You want to know something? He's another jerk I hate. You know what? My guys, when we have to move drug dealers, they do
take
an
off that beret.
Of him.
Take off that beret. Please.
I'm waiting for my medication.
When
Could
we
you
do
please
the movie,
move off the block.
When we do the movie with Elliot Gould.
That was some of her acting.
What? Ooh, what was that? What voice was that?
I think she was even doing a dialect or an accent.
What, could you do that for us again? Who was that you were just doing? Was that Bob Goldthwait? Do that again.
You're directing. You're the ringleader of this circus. You're showing
me the thing. Do it again. Bob Goldthwait for us.
I don't want to do Bob Goldthwait.
You're an actress.
I can't imitate him. No, I don't have to listen to you. You know, I'm tired of men telling me what to do.
Mayor Dinkins.
I love him. Give me his picture.
Why do you love him?
I love Mayor Dinkins.
You feel he's doing a good job?
Yes.
Why? Because he likes the guard?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
That's all it takes.
It's a one-issue thing. Mayor Koch, ex-Mayor Koch.
Does anybody have any spare change? Because I think he needs a job. You know, handouts?
And what do you think of this attractive gentleman, Howard Stern?
That's not Howard Stern.
I know.
You know what this looks like? This is one of those pictures they take at the plastic surgery centers to show you what you'd look like after you dropped about 25 grand. Look at that. The nose. Wait a minute. The nose
Sweetheart.
Needs to come out about 6 more inches.
Hey,
and then
I resent you. That is not
three-dimensional.
Get out of here. You're a loud mouth. You're a loud mouth. You don't know what you're talking about.
I love him too, Howard.
Let me see the cover of one of your pictures from Vogue. It's the same thing.
I wouldn't want you one.
And look at this. Bush and Barbara Bush. George Bush. You don't like
him? You laugh too much.
Reagan, anything? Oh, please. I tell you what, we'll be right back. Don't go away. Lisa Sliwa is here. Well, Lisa informed me she will not take off her beret. She has a bald spot under that beret.
It's true.
I didn't know that.
Whether you believe that or not.
I have one of those punk rock hairdos.
Let me introduce a real actor.
Actor, yes.
A man I have been waiting to meet for a while. I interviewed him several years ago, Robin.
Remember this.
I remember it. Elliot Gould is a real actor. Here's Elliot Gould. What?
All right.
Where's the girl? Where's
there the girl?
Yeah. Where's the girl? Hey, take a seat. Hey, this is an act. Let me explain something. Hey, where's your girls? You're supposed to have girls when Mr. Gould walks in.
Look, he's got a special thing. He's got a guy that wheels him in and out.
Yeah, right. I tell you that. Look at that. I'm going to say something right now, first of all. Welcome to the show, Elliot. It's great to have you on. And
he looks happy to be here.
You know, the producer said Elliot's getting a little antsy out there.
Why did they get antsy?
I've been nervous about doing this interview, Elliot, because I feel, you know, you're a big star. You're someone I admire. Now, let me say something to Lisa Sliwa. This man has
don't bring
appeared.
Him into what's happening.
Let me say
you
something.
And me,
no,
okay?
don't say anything for once. This is a man who has accomplished something in his career. This is a man who starred in some of the greatest movies. He's done television. You see him acting every day. For you to say that you're an actress when none of your things have appeared, she was making reference to the fact, Elliot did movies in the 70s and 80s. The reason, now, Elliot, correct me if I'm wrong. The
I
reason
was at the Academy Awards in 36.
You were in 36, 1936. Yeah. The reason for a couple of years we didn't hear from you, I always heard that it was like, wait a second, Elliot Gould was uncooperative, he wasn't cooperative on the set, all of Hollywood was against him for a while. You know what I'm talking about, right?
Did you hear that?
My father used to say, why doesn't Elliot Gould just take the money? Why doesn't Elliot Gould, this is my father discussing your career.
Yeah, I mean, look at you. You just took the money.
That's right.
Like my son,
well,
you
that's
said.
True.
That's right, like my son. Why doesn't he just prostitute himself, throw his career away just to make a few bucks?
Could you allow me to interview you, loudmouth? What a wench. Hey, Elliot, seriously. You know, I'm going to be a homosexual after tonight. I'm so turned off to women. It's unbelievable.
Well,
I'm so attracted
off to
you.
Men too, okay?
Please tell you, it's not wearing a beret.
We had interviewed before, you said, on radio.
We met at NBC.
NBC, I remember that.
Those imbeciles fired me at NBC, Elliot.
Really?
I'll be honest with you, because I bucked the system. Much like you, I bucked the system. I wouldn't go along. They wanted to tame me. They wanted to tame me. And much like Elliot Gould, a hero of mine, I would not buckle under.
Aren't you over that yet?
I have no idea why they fired me. But seriously, you know what I'm talking about, right?
Were you trouble on the set?
Were you trouble on the set?
No.
No.
You were not?
No, just at home.
No, seriously, you were number one box office. He was number one box office.
Really?
Well, you were, right?
I was on the cover of Time magazine.
Right, and a lot of people then all of a sudden said, wait, we're not going to touch Elliot because Elliot's difficult, right?
Well, that was very embarrassing.
It was, right? But you weren't being difficult, were you?
Well, reality has been difficult for me.
Really?
Yeah.
Elliot and I dropped acid before the show tonight.
Right?
I've got to be honest
reality is difficult for everybody. I mean, imagine being a woman. You walk down the street, you feel like a hunted
hold
animal.
Hold it a second, you.
You feel like Bambi during hunting season.
Elliot?
You've got guys pawing you, guys drooling all over you.
Elliot is in a new movie. I'd rather talk about that. Elliot, what is this new movie? What is this new movie called?
It's The Lemon Sisters.
They sent over a clip where Elliot doesn't talk.
Oh.
Do you know that?
It's the only clip they have.
All right, let's take a look at the clip. Want to take a look at the clip?
I've seen it.
Oh, you, all right, then we'll forget it.
I haven't seen it. Could you show it to me?
He saw it already. What is that? I roll the tape? I know that. Who needs you to tell me that? In front of Mr. Gould. You're embarrassing me like I'm not in control of my own show. This show should be taken off the air.
Don't worry, it will be.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we'll see about that, honey. Already I'm revolutionary. Where is the... Oh,
Lisa,
the
this is your only shot on TV. You better hope it stays on.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, who else is going to have you on? I don't see you on Letterman, sweetheart.
I made quite a large batch of bran cookies this morning, Mrs. F.
Elliot, say something.
Well,
see some acting.
About a cake.
I know.
Make a chocolate cake. We don't have a cake.
Mom.
We'd like to do that. We can do the frosting and...
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, great.
There's really no need, Mrs. F. Why not just leave the baking to me, huh?
Hold it a second, Elliot. This is like Marley Maitland. Seriously, I want to see you act. I want to see you talk and stuff.
This is sort of like a Marcel.
Chance. All right, it's coming
Marcel
up.
Marcel Marceau thing, though. The mime thing is
he doesn't like the dinner. He's not saying anything.
This is a part for you, Lisa. You won't have to have that hard difficulty of memorizing lines.
Or getting rid of that accent.
Oh, look who talks.
I'll take that array off. I'm watching the clip.
Eat up everybody, because there is seconds for those who have clean plates.
And they're really digging in on the first one.
Be quiet.
Okay, Carrot.
Yes, please.
Ah, good girl. Did you hear that? Yes, please. Eat up.
Whoa. Good. That was a good laugh, Elliot. I love it. And let me tell you something. You see the way Elliot laughed? That's what you should learn, Lisa. And you were easy to work with on that, right?
Very. I have
quiet.
Nothing to say.
He didn't say anything. Oh, I would love a part like that. I can never memorize lines. I got a surprise for you.
Good.
The woman you were once married to, Barbara Streisand, is here tonight.
Oh, wonderful.
And I would like to, he was married to Barbara Streisand. There she is.
She
Barbara,
is.
Come on in. Take a seat right here.
Elliot,
how
are
you? Oh, man.
Oh, God.
I don't believe it.
Oh, you
yeah.
Of course, darling.
All right, take a seat, will you?
How are you? You look wonderful.
Oh, man.
Go have a seat.
Take a seat. I'd like to talk with you.
I think I just saw you on 12th Avenue and 28th Street. But you're wearing so many clothes.
Yeah, Let me ask you something. Did you ever cheat on Elliot Gould in your marriage?
Never,
is that why you broke up? Right, don't keep your hands off Mr. Gould.
Very.
Yeah.
We have a child together.
Yes,
you do have a child together, yes.
She even shaved her chest today.
Let me ask you something. As a matter of fact, I'll tell you something, Ms. Streisand. I would better believe that Elliot gave birth to the child than this woman. Right here, I'll be honest with you. Now, let me ask you something. Was it that Elliot...
I didn't realize she was this big, I'll tell you.
I tell you, you are a very big woman. Did Elliot satisfy you sexually?
It was, fabulous.
He's fabulous.
Oh, then what ended the marriage?
Well, Elliot, are you overwhelmed that...
Totally.
What, you haven't seen Barbara in a long time?
No, she hasn't changed.
Yes, she hasn't.
That's a compliment.
Let me tell you something.
That's a compliment.
I would guess the reason that you and Elliot broke up is because you are a difficult woman to live with. You are very dominating. You don't allow a man to be a man. How long have you had a penis? Let me ask you that.
You know, Barbara, I'm glad you're here. Any woman that's strong, you automatically accuse us of envy.
This woman has a penis?
You don't think this woman has a penis? Pick up your dress. What's the matter with you?
It's none of my business.
Let me ask you something. Boy, what a lie. I wish I was Elliot Gould. What a lie.
Barbara Streisand, yes.
Was she singing around the house and stuff? Mm-hmm. Really? Mm-hmm. Was it any good? I mean, was she fun? It was fun? Mm-hmm. He's nauseous from this, I swear to God.
Yeah. Bring back a lot of good memories.
Let me ask you something, Barbara. Have you ever met Barbara Streisand?
No,
you haven't.
No.
Now, who are you, really?
I'm Charles Brand. I'm a lookalike at La Cage aux Folles at Bally's Park Place, an evening at La Cage.
Oh, really?
Bally's Park Place.
And you sing like Barbara as well?
No, I lip sing.
Oh, you lip sing? Yeah, right.
Oh, that voice.
People who need people.
Her voice is too unique.
Do you know what he told me backstage?
What?
That your fantasy is to French kiss Elliot Gould, isn't it?
Oh.
Is that true?
Say,
isn't that the truth?
You want a picture of that, is that it?
It's never going to happen, to be honest. You've never had a homosexual experience, have you?
No.
No, okay, all right.
And it won't.
Have you, Howard?
Have I?
Yeah, Howard, have you?
I'll tell you something. When I was 9 years old, I had a young man come on to me. Another 9-year-old, and there was some towel snapping that went on, and I did get excited. I'll be honest with you, I did get aroused.
Yes, I did.
And now,
Bob, Carol, Ted, and Alice, as played by Howard, Robin, Elliot, and Lisa.
Yeah, hey, this is a, and wait a second. I'm going to direct this first, okay?
Lisa's giving you that look of love. I know. I don't know if you need to direct her or not.
I don't think she needs much direction. Elliot already informed me he's not having a good time. But I think
he looks like he's watching the Mets game. I mean, yeah. Look at him.
Well, come on,
I don't think we're hitting it off.
What is it? Elliot, you want to move closer to
let's,
me?
Let's do it. Let's swap partners.
No, wait a second. Hey, work the cue cards right now. Here, what we're going to do is we're going to be in bed. It's like Bob and Carol, Ted and Alice. Me, Robin, and Elliot want to get it on. Lisa's the holdout.
Okay.
Okay. Picture the scene. Let's see how you act. You're still talking about Elliot Gould. Let's see you, smart pants. Smart pants.
I don't have my pants. Oh.
All right, let's go. Here we go. All right, Elliot, you go.
Come on, let's do it. Let's swap partners.
I'm so turned on.
Finally, the four of us in bed naked. Let's do it, man. I'm ready.
Yo, man. The joggers trials dead, like, you know what I mean? They can't even decide to put these away. You know what I'm saying?
Read the cue card.
She's spitting on me.
A two live crew. You know what I'm talking about?
What?
That was terrible.
I don't need
sex. I need to talk to somebody. I need a man I can talk to. You know what
all
I'm
right.
Saying?
Yeah, I know.
You're get into it.
Tight.
Kiss me.
Yeah. Yo, Robin, are you kidding me? I'd stick to you and never come off.
Just go with the flow.
Yeah, you know, I need what she needs. Come on, kiss me, Lisa, please. Come on, let's get it on. It's time.
Lisa, it's your turn.
I think Rafer should be castrated. And I'm sick and tired of being looked at like a sex object.
Yeah?
If you guys don't turn those cue cards any faster, I'm going to start ad-libbing, okay?
This is terrible.
This is like, I mean, please, can I just say what I want to say? I think a woman should be able to walk down the streets without having
but
guys
but I just want to make love.
No, you have to stuff your beret in your mouth.
Somebody should put something in her mouth.
Come on, lay a bologna sandwich on me. What is this? Ow!
She can't act, obviously. Oh, with your own shoe,
you know
too.
You are so masculine, it's not even funny. You are the world's worst actress. I'll tell you something. If anybody hires her to act, they're out of their mind. Elliot, she can't even act.
We were doing really well until Lisa broke
Lisa,
everything
up. Lisa, you can continue now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, but we're breaking the bed. Come on. Nothing's even happening.
Oh, this is a real good bed, you guys. I like this.
Let me mention Elliot's movie one more time, because Lisa's an embarrassment. Elliot, the new movie...
Well, that's not what you told me during the break.
The new movie... You're so masculine. The new movie is with Diane Keaton.
And Lisa.
And Lisa.
Oh, right. God.
And we can see... Is that theaters now?
On the 31st. It opens nationally.
It's good to see you back in movies. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, thanks.
You're such a great actor.
Too. Thanks,
I mean,
Howard.
You're really awesome. Elliot Gould digs us, man.
Yeah,
he's staying.
He's hanging out.
He's hanging out.
I didn't think he was having a good time, but it must be all right.
I got rid of that loudmouth, Lisa Sliwa.
Yeah, now we can calm down and really talk.
She's great. I love Lisa. You know, I like a woman who's opinionated and strong. It's just that, you know,
She hurt you, though.
She did. She threw the boot. During the big acting scene, she threw the boot at my genitals, and you saw how in pain I was. And yet, my acting is so superb, I didn't let on for a minute, to be honest with you. Hey, am I rolling the John Kennedy piece first? John Kennedy Jr.?
I have no idea what we're doing.
Yeah, you know, okay. Elliot, you'll like this.
I'm sure.
You know John Kennedy Jr.?
No.
What's with that kid? He can't pass this test. How many times has he taken that test, Robin?
3 times now, Howard. He's waiting for the results of test number 3.
Well, there's a new TV commercial he has, and I'd like you to see it. All right? Then we'll come back and do some news for you. Watch this.
I'm JFK Jr. Would you like to earn a law degree without your sex life missing a stroke?
Then order JFK Jr.'s new video, Books and Babes. I know what you're saying to yourself. What does this spoiled rich brat know about studying?
Quite frankly, nothing. I'm so stupid, I actually believe my Uncle Ted's Chappaquiddick story.
But after flunking his bar exam 17 times, he knows everything there is to know about study habits. Study tip number 1. Use Daryl Hannah's thighs as a bookstand. Study tip number two. Shave the answers to the bar exam on the back of a fellow student's head.
Come on, Denzel. Do me the square. Do me a square, man.
I don't think so.
Didn't you get into NYU on a grant from my family?
Oh, man.
Study tip number three. Learn to convince professors that your low test scores deserve special attention.
Mr. Kennedy, I'm afraid I'm going to have to give you a 68 on your exam.
Era, please, Era. I'm so upset. I'm under a lot of pressure. No one understands me, Era. Feel my bicep. Look, Professor, couldn't we talk about this over a bottle of champagne, let's say, Era, at your place?
I don't think so.
I'm so upset, Era. I can only make love, 10 times a night.
Can I say 68 on your paper?
I meant 98.
Meet me after class.
Era, now I can't call you, Era. You have to call me.
Dial 1-800-DUMB-STUD. 1-800-DUMB-STUD. Shouldn't you call now?
Era, as Daddy used to say, it's as easy as Marilyn Monroe.
Yes, what a commercial that is. It's very nice, JFK Jr.
I can't imagine that being nice John John.
That. Wasn't that nice of him to do that? He's a great actor.
Yeah.
He really is. He's
good
the world's,
sense of humor. Good
world's
sense
sexiest
of humor.
Man.
No, has,
nothing to,
say
has nothing to do with the fact that he's John Kennedy Jr. Believe me, if he was Howard Stern, he would not be the world's sexiest man. It's just because of his name, as you know, Elliot. Both Elliot and I had to come up the hard way. We didn't have a rich father or mother or any of that kind of fame. We had to do it all on our own, didn't we? Mm. All right. Elliot's taking off his sunglasses.
Oh, good.
Robin, now it's time to find out what's going on in the news. Elliot, you feel free to comment.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, I guess you both know about the whole Iraq situation. Mm. Saddam Hussein is making lots of threats. He's going to round up Americans.
I only wish I could go over there.
Oh, please.
But as you know, I'm poolside this weekend, Robin.
I don't even want to hear it.
And Elliot's busy with movies. Don't you wish you could go over and fight? Of course. No. All right.
He's a smart man. He doesn't want to fight, but it looks like we're not going to be able to settle that one peacefully.
Is that right?
But thank goodness we're able to live together in this country.
Yes.
For example, our cameraman, Scott Salem, mm-hmm. was out this week covering the jogger trial.
Yes.
And he found two friendly Americans discussing South Africa.
Oh, perfect. Here it is.
You went on the East River Drive.
You went for apartheid.
No, I don't. I'm against it. Yes. Yes, I have. I got a job. That means I'm against it.
What kind of job you have?
I work on the f***ing bridges that have fallen down. I'm not the one who knocked it.
Where do you get the natural resource? Where do you get the material from?
I don't know, man. From Africa. That's the injustice in the world. You can't change the world.
Who controls the nursing home?
You can only change yourself.
Who controls the nursing home?
The West Indies.
Wait a second. This is going on outside the jogger trial.
Yes.
Look at what's going. Look what people have time for. You and I have careers. You're trying to eat Nutrisystem. Me, I'm trying to make it on television, on radio. Who are these people? Why do they have such time on their hands? Why do they have so?
Hey, look, there's a whole crowd of people around them watching this. It's like street theater.
Thank God Elliot Gould's here to give us the answer. Why do people have so much free time?
It's the price of gas.
It's got them all walking? Is that what you're saying?
Elliot's scaring me, Robin. I'm going to be
he
honest.
He did say he had trouble with reality. Huh? Well, let's watch a little more. Let's see what these two guys come up with.
If you don't behave yourself, I'm bringing Barbara Streisand back out.
Bensonhurst guys are scumbags.
All y'all are guilty.
These guys are scumbags.
All y'all are guilty.
Oh, I'm a white devil, right? I'm a white devil. Yeah.
No, I know.
I've oppressed you personally.
I didn't say you was a devil.
I oppressed you personally.
What is this, MTV? How is the world ever going to be one?
I don't know, Howard.
How is the world ever going to be one, Elliot?
Nutrisystem.
He's got all the answers.
It's a difficult question, but...
I want to know whether Barbara Streisand left him or he left Barbara Streisand. I could care less about anything. That's all I want. I just want to know every facet of your personal life. My God, what a life you've had.
Well, on to other things, All right. This week I found out about this new product. I'm really happy. I'm very excited. Now, this is mainly designed for parents. They're going to start commercially distributing this. They've already been using it. The Coast Guard uses it. The Customs Department uses it. This is called Drug Alert. And with this spray, Howard, you can find out if anyone around you is using drugs.
How does that work?
I'll tell you exactly how it works. This is the marijuana hashish spray. Bottle number two.
This is not a joke.
No, this is a real product.
My God.
Now, what you do, if you think one of your kids is using marijuana...
Right.
Jackie, would you give me some of your tapes, your books...
No.
Come on, no. Jackie, come on.
Jimmy, give me some of your
tape. Give me a tape, a book.
Why don't you just spray cup. Jackie with it?
Yeah, I mean, I might have to rub him down.
Right. What do you want, really?
Yeah, take a joke.
Give me anything that you might have left some residue in.
Yeah, give me that. Yeah, right, this. Yeah, go ahead.
All right, let's see. I just take this tissue and I wipe the surface.
No kidding.
Oops, I almost broke it. Oh, well. Let's see what happens. Then you take your spray, you right. shake the can.
What's that?
And you spray.
Jesus.
Let's
and what
see.
Do you get? If it turns what?
If it turns brown, and I'm seeing a few brown specks here.
Three bugs just died.
No, it's true. I'm seeing little flecks of brown. That was a totally white piece of paper.
Yes, it is brown.
Any indication? Look, there's plenty of brown on this paper, Howard.
So you understand what this means, Elliot? If you were to be smoking pot, if I was to spray you with this and you turn brown.
Can we check your glasses?
Yeah, Elliot. There it is.
All right, and we'll just spray a little more here.
I'm going to say it turns brown, judging from tonight's appearance. I'm going to say it turns brown, Elliot.
I'll say Elliot's been a good boy.
Yep, no brown.
Elliot's been a good boy.
Elliot, you don't do any drugs, you don't smoke pot or anything?
No.
You do not?
No.
I want to count up the amount of words Elliot's uttered on this show.
Well, Elliot, what do you do? Because we want to do some of it. No.
Okay. And yet Elliot's been a great guest. I can't explain. Are we paying Elliot by the syllable? I just want to know. What is that?
He's not trying to rip us off, I'll tell you that much.
He sure comes alive during that, when you ask him about the movie, though. I'll tell you that.
And, of course, the sad news this week is about Curtis Mayfield.
Right.
He came to Brooklyn to do a concert.
Did you hear about this?
Mm.
Yeah.
And got hit on the head. If for anybody who doesn't remember who Curtis Mayfield is, he's the great singer who wrote the theme song Superfly for the movie and all the music for that.
Was this a racial incident, Robin?
I don't think so.
All right, yeah.
Do we have the Curtis
Mayfield? Oh, there
he is.
That's Curtis. He's a cool dude. And I feel, you know, let me say something. The incompetence of people. I mean, this is a very sad thing. A guy goes on stage. What kind of incompetence sets up heavy electrical equipment and then... Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh,
wow!
Man. Well, now we know what kind of incompetence it takes.
Right. How's that for acting, huh, Elliot?
Oh.
I thought I handled that very well. Anyway, listen.
That's what's happening.
I want to thank Elliot Gould for coming on tonight. Stuttering John's going to be here with an interview with Margot Kidder and Donahue and a couple other people. You got to see this Ted Williams interview. You've never seen anything like it. Go see Elliot Gould's new movie with Diane Keaton called The Lemon Sister.
Yeah.
Welcome, welcome. All right, well, we got some good stuff for you now. We got Stuttering John, who goes out and does interviews every week. This week we've got Margot Kidder, Ted Williams, and Donahue, right?
Donahue.
Gary, by the way, that veil is working. You're never going to lose your spot on this show. Continue to wear that veil.
Thank you, boss.
Because the teeth get distracting, Robin. That's
yeah,
the problem.
Yeah, you're so much more attractive this way.
Really?
You'd go out with me?
And that sort of,
I'm considering it.
That sort of yarmulke look, that Muslim yarmulke thing, is just very, very attractive.
I think it's him. I really do.
How nice Gary's eyes went to.
Yeah, really.
Are you there? It's true.
That line he gets out.
His eyes are so expressive like that. You know, John, when
How
you...
How are you, Howard, today?
Yeah, very good. Okay. All right, let me show you Ted Williams. You went to a baseball card convention?
Baseball card convention.
And what happened? Ted Williams was there signing cards?
He signs autographs for $40 a pop.
For how much?
$40 a pop.
$40 a pop. All right. So Ted Williams makes money by signing baseball cards. Stuttering John moves next to him, and the interview begins. Take a look at this. Okay.
Congratulations on your illustrious career.
Yeah, thank you.
And can I ask you, do you wake up every morning and thank God that you don't play for George Steinbrenner?
No, not a bit. I think he's done a lot of good things for this game. You know, when a guy's down, they can criticize all they like. He's been quite a colorful guy in this game. You can find some things to criticize about anybody, but I certainly am not one guy to criticize.
Do you know all the words to the national anthem?
No, I wish I did be able. I don't sing.
By any chance, did you ever accidentally fart in the catcher's face?
Pardon?
By any chance, did you ever accidentally fart in the catcher's face?
Who the hell are you? For John's sake, that kind of damn question. See you later.
Okay.
You're lucky a man who hits 406 didn't smack you in the head with a bat.
I guess the women will stop writing now.
Yeah, right. Dear John, I love you. I love you so much.
You want me to come on the set and wear a big nose?
All right, here we go. Shut up. I'll throw you right off the show. You won't know what hit you. All right, here was Margot Kidder, who's looking a little thin these days.
Where did you meet Margot Kidder?
This is at the...
This is at a charity softball game for...
Oh, come on, man.
That's not nice. Let him do that.
Yeah, see, this is why I stutter, because he let me finish.
Right. Where did you meet her? Quick.
For women in film.
Oh, I love it.
Women in film.
The last time you make fun of my nose, you... All right, here we go. Margot Kidder, Stuttering John. Margot didn't have too good sense of humor. All right.
Your makeup doesn't stand well with
you. Hi, I'm Margot. My name is John. I'm from the Howard Stern Summer Show.
Hi, John.
How are you? Can you answer a few questions for me?
Yeah, sure.
All right, did you know that Clark Kent is Superman's secret identity?
Of course.
Is the Man of Steel, is he well endowed or hung like a safety pin?
I refuse to answer that on the grounds that it might incriminate me.
Really? Okay. did you know that...
Where are you from?
Howard Stern Summer Show.
Uh-huh.
Did you know that Tyne Daly is married to a black guy?
Yes.
Does it bother you in any way?
Well, what kind of question? Where are you guys?
All right. Well, that was Margot Kidder at the wedding.
Oh, just
forget it.
Okay.
Excuse me. Where are you guys from? What show?
The Howard Stern Summer Show.
As soon as these publicists hear the Howard Stern Summer Show, they shut right. Oh, I love it. Howard Stern Summer Show.
Oh, come on.
That's unbelievable.
Oh, if you had some food, Margot would have stayed there all day.
Yeah. I tell you, Margot Kidder, you better eat something, honey. I tell you, how long she got to live? Okay, now let's take a look at Donahue. What happened? Where'd you meet him?
We met him at the same softball game.
What was that again?
Uh-huh. For the women in film. Look at that.
I wouldn't be a wheeler. Hi, Phil.
Why is winning this game so important?
Well, it's about trying to, win this game and get on with the rest of my life. This is very important. I know you make a big light thing out of this, but there's a lot going on here. We're going
to
win.
Can I ask you something, Phil? This is for the Howard Stern Summer Show to be taped up for broadcast.
It is, yeah.
Next question. Did you ever use your glasses for evil purposes?
No, never.
Yeah. Do you ever use your glasses to burn ants by pointing them at the sun?
No, I've never done that.
Do you and Marlo practice safe sex?
Yes.
Have you socked anyone in an airport recently?
No, I haven't punched anybody out.
Why are you so nice to Morton Downey? Does he have embarrassing pictures of you?
Morton Downey's my pal, and television needs him.
Oh, yeah.
Would you pray that Oprah would eat until she explodes?
That's not funny.
Oh, that's great. I love it. I love it. I like seeing that whole scenario. I like John waiting for Phil in wait.
Phil shifted gears.
Gary, you look like Marlo right now. You know, she wears that to the bedroom. Hey, listen, we want you to write us letters. I'll tell you why. We're very lonely and we need to hear from you. Because to tell you the truth, this keeps us motivated. So write to the Howard Stern Show, 9 Broadcast Plaza, Secaucus, New Jersey, 07096. We want to hear from you. Ronnie Spector's coming in next to do a song parody about Maury and Connie. Don't go away. You don't want to miss this. All right.
Good to see you again. Oh, God.
Well, there's a greeting.
Yes, that's a good greeting. Howard.
Ronnie Spector, of course. let me go through your resume, as they say. Ronnie Spector, of course. What is your resume, Ronnie? I forget.
I don't know.
No, the Ronettes, of course, right? First, let me tell everyone that you're going to be at the Bottom Line September 7th and 8th.
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
And, which is going to be great.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, you're as good as you ever were. You understand what I'm saying. Let's do the song parody. Come on, Ronnie. I'm ready
for this. Okay, I'm going to do... I got my girls back here.
These are the Ronettes?
The Ronettes of the 90s.
Ooh, yeah, honey. I know you want it. Any of you girls, $50?
Abigail and Rachel.
to jump on my lap and make love to me.
Oh, jeez.
No, but in all seriousness, and who was that other woman you had with you? The one with the huge breast that was
That's
running?
My sister-in-law.
That's your sister-in-law. Oh, God bless her.
Oh, she's here for you, huh?
Can't she
sing? She wants you bad. She
now, this
you.
Is a song about Maury Povich and Connie Chung.
Yes.
They've been unable to have a baby.
Well, I heard right. about that.
And we'll do it like MTV, kind of. Like, you see behind you, there'll be, like, pictures of Chinese babies and different
Chinese...
It'll
be like a video.
Okay.
It'll be like a rock video.
That's wonderful. I'm going to sing Be My Baby, but about...
But about... That's right, all right?
Wonderful. Let's go, guys.
And girls, you know your part? Girls,
they
do you
rehearse.
You have your green card?
Do I have my cue?
Did you guys rehearse? You got cue cards and everything. Okay.
Rehearse and everything.
All set.
All right.
I'm going to do my best, guys.
All right, do your best. Give it a try. Don't be nervous, because I'm here.
Don't be nervous, he says.
Ha. All right, here we go. Are we ready? Make the music loud.
I read that Connie Chung wants a baby with that Paul Murray Povich. She must be crazy. You're not a news commentator, not a baby incubator. Stop fighting Mother Nature. Go out and buy a dog for Connie Chung.
She can't have a
she
baby.
She can't have a baby.
She can't have a baby.
Just for Murray.
She can't have a
it's
baby.
Way too old.
She can't
Whoa.
Have a baby.
When they first met, Connie was on the go. But now she wants a kid. And her belly won't grow. Whoa. Maybe Marie likes. Oh, God. There ain't no way in hell a fetus could come out. So poor Connie.
She can.
It's a joke.
You're the best.
It's a joke.
A joke.
She can't have a baby.
She can't have a baby. She can't have a baby. Whoa. I love you, Connie. You're
yeah.
the best.
We got it. You're great. You're going to be at the bottom line, of course.
Yes, September 7th and 8th. Come on by.
All right, everybody, go see the great Ronnie Spector, and we got to get out of here. Maybe we should do the real song.
The real, yeah,
get yeah. up here. We'll do the dance and everything, everybody.
Come on, girls.
And we'll see you next Saturday night. Thank you to Lisa Sliwa and Elliot Gould and who else was here? Nobody else was here. Ronnie Spector.
Come on, guys.
Here we go.
Yeah. Come on, Robin.
It's a real song.
The night we
here it is. Now.
I needed you so.
Get ready to party each weeknight with the hottest stars in Hollywood, beginning with the Arsenio Hall Show at 11. Then at midnight, there's music and dancing on the Party Machine with Nia Peebles. And tonight at 8, one good bite deserves another. Roy Scheider stars in Jaws 2 on Channel 13.